Welcome to Civil Engineering Ed. 3C, wearing coat. The wearing coat is the topmost protective layer laid over the bridge deck slab. It serves as the interface between vehicular traffic and the structural concrete deck. The primary function of the wearing coat is to safeguard the deck from mechanical abrasion, weather exposure, and water infiltration. This layer is generally made of bituminous concrete, though cement mortar or polymer-based materials can also be used. The typical thickness ranges from 25 millimeters to 75 millimeters, depending on the bridge's traffic load and design life. The wearing coat must be water-resistant, skid-proof, and durable enough to withstand the stresses of braking and tire friction. It should also have good bonding properties with the deck surface to prevent delamination. In addition to protection, the wearing coat enhances riding comfort and vehicle safety. Drainage provisions are integrated into the wearing coat design to allow quick runoff of rainwater, minimizing hydrostatic pressure and reducing the risk of skidding. Regular maintenance, inspection, and resurfacing of the wearing coat are crucial. If this layer deteriorates, it can expose the deck slab to moisture and chemical attack, leading to corrosion of reinforcement and structural weakening. 4. Components of substructure. The substructure of a bridge is its supporting backbone, located below the superstructure and designed to transfer all imposed loads to the foundation soil. It includes abutments positioned at the ends of the bridge. They support vertical loads and retain the approach embankments. Wing walls, extensions of abutments, they hold back soil at the bridge ends, guiding traffic smoothly. Piers, vertical columns that support the superstructure at intermediate spans for longer bridges. Foundations, base structures that transfer the entire load to the ground. These may be shallow foundations like isolated, combined, strip, or raft footings when the soil is strong near the surface. For deeper or weaker soils, deep foundations like piles, wells, or caissons are used. The choice of foundation depends on load intensity, soil bearing capacity, water table, and seismic conditions. A well-designed substructure ensures stability and prevents differential settlement. And that wraps up our journey into the design of bridges. From understanding the roles of superstructure and substructure to exploring the vital components like deck slabs, bearings, abutments, and foundations. Bridges may appear simple on the surface, but they are the result of intricate engineering and deep planning. Every element is carefully designed to work in harmony, ensuring durability, safety, and functionality for years to come. As we've seen, even components like curbs, handrails, and wearing coats play a huge role in both structural performance and user comfort. Understanding bridge design isn't just for engineers, it's for anyone who values the infrastructure that shapes our daily lives. With this knowledge, you're one step closer to seeing the world through the eyes of a civil engineer. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon, so you never miss our future videos. Let us know in the comments what civil engineering topic you want us to cover next. This is Civil Engineering Edge, and we'll see you in the next video, where learning builds the future.